Let me help you piece together what is going on with Microsoft Copilot for Sales. This is now available. It is a brand new thing that combines your CRM data and what's going on in the Microsoft 365 data into a mega Copilot. Here is what's happening. We have got experiences that exist currently. If you're a Dynamics 365 Sales Enterprise or Premium user, you've got some features in there that were previously known as Sales Copilot. That's not going to be a brand anymore. This is now becoming Copilot in Dynamics 365 Sales. It's also referred to as Copilot for Sales Standard. And then a new license, new name, Microsoft Copilot for Sales, which includes the combination of the Microsoft 365 Copilot and a whole bunch of premium features. Confused much? Yeah, me too. I've got this worked out, so stay with me and jump ahead to the particular chapter of the particular scenario you're in, or let's go along for the ride together. This is a grid from the Microsoft website. I've got the link in the description here that explains the what in the best way that I possibly can. So I'm going to go through this for you and show you where each of these things fits. So to start with, the concept of what you're getting inside Dynamics 365 or this sort of Copilot for Sales standard license. So this is the experiences that exist in Dynamics 365 right now. If you're a Salesforce user, keep watching because there are options here for you too. But for now, we have Copilot experiences in Dynamics 365 Sales, which include things like ask questions, what's happened, prepare me for my meeting, summarize my opportunities, summarize my lead, those types of things. Another example of that there. All of that is the experience of that's being referred to as Copilot in Dynamics 365 Sales. There is also experiences coming. This was announced in the Wave 1 2024 release of this full screen view. Same concept, but instead of the sidecar, you're getting this much nicer view, but it's still inside Dynamics 365 Sales and asking those questions. There are experiences in Outlook. Now, this is going to diverge as the product develops into here's your standard experience in Outlook, which is what we've seen up till now. So this has got things like summarize an email, summarize the email thread and copy that into your Dynamics 365 system. It connects you up to Teams deal rooms. You can update all of your information about contacts, opportunities, accounts, other custom tables in there and generate emails using generative AI. And there's also a standard experience in Teams, which is this sort of two parts to this. One of them is the deal room or the account room where you can collaborate and it automatically creates that and links it all up. And the other one is this conversation intelligence where you're getting action points and summaries and transcripts of the meeting. So all of these things are the standard experience. So what more do you get? Because of course there's a price tag on this. What more do you get by getting this new Microsoft Copilot for Sales that you don't have if you've already got the standalone license? And we'll come back to how that works. Why would you want to do this? So this is where, and in the Wave 1 2024 release, there's actually quite a lot of features in another section called Microsoft Copilot for Sales that actually list out a whole bunch of them. The easiest way to understand this is that it's combining Copilot for Microsoft 365. So that's that one that we've all been waiting for that is $30 per user per month. All of the prices here are US dollars. Convert to your own currency. $30 per user per month that does all of that stuff around being able to say, you know, create documents and create PowerPoint and do fancy things in Excel and the Teams chat. I've got many videos on that here. What we're seeing with this, what more do you get with Microsoft Copilot for Sales in this new license now, is those things combined so that this is the experience that looks like what you get in that Microsoft Copilot for Microsoft 365. I'm in Word, help me draft a document, but this is a sales scenario and it's tied to your CRM data. Help me prep for the pitch meeting with, now we can bring in stuff about the customer, but we can also bring in data from the CRM system. So now we've got a document of something we've worked on with them, opportunity summary, open tasks. This is early days, but this is the direction it's going. And this will be the value in having that new license is that you're actually now, this is reinventing CRM. I think by the end of the year, this is going to be a completely different landscape. Your CRM, it's not isolated. honestly, as a salesperson, you work in Word, Outlook, Excel, Teams, all of these things, this really brings them closer together. We're not just talking like integration with Outlook anymore. This is now your productivity tools, AI on your productivity tools combined with all of your business data, all of your proposals, your statements of work, your requirements, documents, whatever it is else that you're working with, plus the CRM data. So early days right now. So this is one preview of what we're going to get, an experience in Word. That's the first one. There'll also be premium experiences in Outlook and Teams. We've seen more of the premium experience coming through in Teams in the Wave 1 release. So this is meeting notes in Teams. So the standard experience does a transcript and helps you with action points. But this is a level up on that. We're getting kind of a summarized meeting notes, follow-up tasks, and you'll see these are buttons that you can press. So for instance, you can press the update opportunity and that will update it in Sales. So all of those pain points we have about no one ever wants to do their data entry. If you are doing remote calling with Teams, you've got that option to go straight in there. The other one we saw as a preview in one of the Wave 1 videos was PowerPoint as well. That'll be a little bit further down the track, but the same concept of being able to bring that into PowerPoint. So how do I buy it? What's it going to cost? I'm going to go through the scenarios here of where you might be at and therefore what path you need to be on and what you can do. Let's start from the top here. Minimum license requirements. So because Microsoft Copilot for Sales, I'm really focusing on getting the product name right here. I pop a comment in if you notice me trip over. I'm quite sure somewhere in this video I'll call it the wrong thing. Microsoft Copilot for Sales, minimum license requirements. Firstly, you have to be using Dynamics 365 Sales or Salesforce. Those are the two CRMs that it works with. And you need to be using one of these licenses with your productivity suite. So Microsoft 365 E3 or E5, Office 365 E3 or E5, or Business Standard or Business Premium. These are the same prerequisites as the Microsoft Copilot for Microsoft 365 license, because it is essentially a combination of Sales Copilot things and Microsoft 365 Copilot things. The underlying minimum requirements are the same as they are for Microsoft 365 Copilot, plus you need to have a CRM, one of those two CRM systems. With me so far? We good? So here's how you buy it. If you have Salesforce, or if you have nothing so far, you don't have any of this capability so far, you can buy this SKU for $50 per user per month. And what you're getting for that is all of these things. So you will get the standard experiences in Outlook, plus the premium experiences in Outlook as they come through, the Teams standard and premium experiences, as well as all of those other things like Copilot with your CRM data in Word, PowerPoint, Excel, OneNote, etc. being, there'll be a big roadmap around all of that. If you have a look, for instance, here, say premium Copilot experiences in Outlook, the standard experience is giving you, you know, create a contact, create an account, update those things, summarize the email thread, copy it to Dynamics, all awesome stuff. But this is now analyzing and doing cleverer. It's all very sales focused. Recommend CRM updates. It'll like recommend what data you should update. Give you pulling out, do you have the budget authority need timing out of the conversation thread? Same with those types of things in Teams. So we're only just seeing the start of this. As I said, this is a reinvention of the concept of CRM, but this is essentially what you're getting. So for $50 per user per month, you're actually getting Copilot for Microsoft 365, which is normally $30, plus the all of that stuff in the sales world applied over the top of it in Outlook and Teams and Word and PowerPoint and inside your CRM. So that's your starting point. But what if you've already bought something in the past? So let's go through this. I already have Microsoft Sales Copilot. This was the previous, up until the 1st of February, this was the thing that you could get, the standalone license that people had purchased. This is what is on the FAQ licensing website. Link is in the description here. This is all current. I'm recording this, you know, 5th of February. So if things have changed, please check the link. So what happens if you've bought that standalone subscription? This replaces it, but you will continue to be able to use what you've got. If you want to get the new features that include Microsoft 365 Copilot, you will need to upgrade. So if you've bought it, you're going to this is a bit of a theme across all of the licensing. Whatever you've already got access to doesn't change. You will still be able to use that. We've already got Dynamics 365 Sales Enterprise. Up until now, the Sales Copilot, that's the old name, was included in Dynamics 365 Sales Enterprise. That is still true, but the new stuff, all of the premium stuff, all of the stuff that's dependent on Microsoft 365 Copilot is not included in Sales Enterprise anymore. So if you've got Sales Enterprise and you've got those Copilot features that we looked at earlier in the video, here's my sidecar in Dynamics, summarizing my opportunities, suggesting what next, standard Sales Copilot features in Outlook and Teams, you can still keep using all of those things. Those things are still included in your Dynamics 365 Sales license, but you don't get all of the new stuff without having the Microsoft 365 Copilot, because that's a whole other thing. So what happens if you're in that situation? No change unless you choose to buy something else. You will still get the standard experiences that you've got, and it will look like this. So this is the column here of the things you've got. I'm highlighting out the Copilot experiences. The top two lines there are actually distinguishing between the Sales Enterprise and Sales Premium license, just in terms of sales automation features. Those are some important things, but not the subject of this video. So those two top two lines you can just don't worry about for now. Dynamics 365 Sales Enterprise, you will get these capabilities that you already have. You'll continue to use them, but you'll notice you're not getting all those extra premium capabilities. What if you would like those extra premium capabilities, I hear you ask? You did ask that, didn't you? That's the obvious next question. You need to buy the whole Copilot license. There's not a way of sort of upgrading it, because you're actually already getting that stuff kind of included in your Dynamics license. So this would effectively be $95 plus $50 per user per month. So for your sales users, if you want that, that's your upgrade path if you would like to do it. Now, it looks slightly different if you are on the Sales Premium side. So same rules apply. No, the Copilot for Sales Premium is not, sorry, the this is so confusing. Microsoft Copilot for Sales is not included in Sales Dynamics 365 Sales Premium. Everything you've got still applies. These are the same two things from before. But the difference here is that you can add on. You don't have to buy the whole thing separately. So you're already paying more for your Sales Premium, and you can add on for $30 per user per month. So if you're in Enterprise, you have to buy the $50 SKU, but if you're in Premium, you can add on a $30 per user per month. So you'll get this equation. So your options here, if you're a Dynamics user, if you're on Dynamics Sales Enterprise, it's $95 plus $50. I really should have added this up beforehand. $145, or here $135 plus $30 is $165. So there is a slightly higher price point still, because you are getting that extra line of advanced other AI features in that application. So if you're on Dynamics 365 Sales Premium, you can upgrade by just buying, effectively you're just buying the Microsoft 365 Copilot piece, which is $30 per user per month. I already have Copilot for Microsoft 365. First of all, lucky you. How's it going? Then what you can do is just buy the Copilot for Sales for $20 per user per month, if that's what you would like to do. So if you're a Salesforce user and you've got the Microsoft 365 Copilot and you want to add this in to connect up to Salesforce, that would be an option for you. If you are if you haven't even started with CRM yet and you've already got that, and then you decide to get on board with Dynamics 365 or Salesforce, then you can do that. Effectively, it's going to cost you $50 per user per month to get Microsoft Copilot for Sales. The only thing that's different here is that if you've already bought a premium capability one way or the other, the add-on price basically tops it up to $50 per user per month. Full details are online here, and check out my video for more on Microsoft Copilot for Sales. Hit me up with any questions. I will find out as many answers as I possibly can. Thanks for watching.